A daring fellow is the jewel of the world. This is a quote by whom? In the Playboy of the Western world. Who is the daring fellow? Christy Mahon. Christy Mahon is a daring fellow. And who says a daring fellow is the jewel of the world in that play? It is Flaherty or Michael Flaherty. That is the owner of the, Michael Flaherty is the owner of the pub where this thing is happening. The play is happening in Michael Flaherty's pub. Did you understand? Okay. Then next is where is the play Riders to the Sea set? Riders to the Sea is a play set in Aran Islands. Which island in Aran Islands is it set in? That is the question. Guys, today I can't see your messages. I don't know whether you are answering. The play Riders to the Sea is set in which island of Aran Islands? It is Ainish Man. It is set in Ainish Man. Sarah Casey and Michael Byrne are characters in the novel. Do you know who wrote this novel? There is a Irish writer. No, sorry, not novel. It is a play. Sorry, play. It's a big mistake. Sarah Casey and Michael Byrne are characters in the Irish writer's play. Which play? Irish writer is J.M. Synge. We are talking about J.M. Synge. It is The Tinker's Wedding. The Tinker's Wedding. Sarah Casey and Michael Byrne. Sarah Casey and Michael Byrne are characters in the play The Tinker's Wedding. When was Pygmalion premiered? When was Pygmalion premiered? Do you know the answer? 1913 it is. That is a very important thing. 1913. How many scenes are there in St. John? How many scenes are there in St. John? There are 6 scenes and an epilogue. This epilogue is very famous, where St. John is speaking to her enemies. The people who killed her at stake, St. John is speaking to her, speaking to them in epilogue. That is very important. Okay, guys. What is the 1923 tragicomedy play by Sean O'Casey set during the Irish War of Independence? There was a 1923 tragicomedy play by Sean O'Casey set during the Irish War of Independence. What is that play? It is The Shadow of a Gunman. The Shadow of a Gunman. Which play is not part of Sean O'Casey's Dublin trilogy? Which play is not part of Sean O'Casey's Dublin trilogy? It is The Wild Goose. The Wild Goose. Sean O'Casey's Dublin trilogy is Shadow of a Gunman, Juno and the Paycock, and The Plough and the Stars. Okay, now. Who wrote September 1, 1939? A poem written on the outbreak of the Second World War. That is a very famous poem by a poem written on the outbreak of the Second World War. It is by W.H. Auden. W.H. Auden was living in New York at this time. And this is the day on which the Second World War began. The best known English language war poets of the Second World War wrote Raiders, Dawn and other poems. Which is the author? Who is the author? which is the best known English language war poet of the Second World War? Alan Lewis is a war poet. Remember, Alan Lewis is a Second World War poet. Okay, in our encyclopedia, I have given an account of him. Name the poem in which Keith Douglas mentions the First World War poet Isaac Rosenberg. You may not know it, right? Remember, Keith Douglas is a contemporary poet. He writes about Isaac Rosenberg in Desert Flowers. He writes about Isaac Rosenberg in Desert Flowers. Who is among the first rank of poets who saw active service in the Second World War? Who is among the first rank of poets who saw active service in the Second World War and is known for the poem Song of the Dying Gunner, AA1? Have you heard this name? It is Charles Crossley. I am telling you these names so that you will look them up. They are all very important poets these days. Second World War poets is a very important group of poets. We all know about First World War poets, but it is important to look up Second World War poets also, okay? Which British poet and academic is known for his best known poem, Soldiers Bathing, written during the Second World War? Please read about Second World War poets. I have marked it already. It is F.T. Prince. F.T. Prince. Please remember to use this discount code when you subscribe to Unacademy. MCQ literature course through, non-British literature course through MCQs and complete course is also there. Now, in which of Noel Coward's plays, in which of Noel Coward's plays does Charles, a novelist, communicate with Elvira's ghost? Elvira is his previous wife. Noel Coward is important. They always ask about Noel Coward these days. Noel Coward's plays are Vortex, Two Lives, Private Lives. Answer is Blythe Spirit. Noel Coward's plays are important. Please remember. In Noel Coward's Blythe Spirit, Charles, a novelist, communicates with Elvira. Who keeps a stuffed pet dog in the end game? Which character has a stuffed pet dog? And it is a maimed dog. It is invalid dog. Lame dog. It is Ham. It is Ham who keeps a stuffed pet dog. Which play by Edward Bond portrays Shakespeare in his last years of life? You might know that Shakespeare is represented as a materialist. He is interested only in money making. It is Bingo. Edward Bond portrays Bingo. In Bingo, Shakespeare is a he is trying to make money only. He is not interested in anything else. Tom Stoppard's one act play, Real Inspector Hound, it's a parody of which novel? That also is famous, you might know. Tom Stoppard's one-act play, Real Inspector Hound, is a parody of which famous work? It is The Mouse Trap by Agatha Christie. Tom Stoppard's one-act play, Real Inspector Hound, is a parody of The Mouse Trap by Agatha Christie. Whom does Henry Carr not meet in Zurich? Henry Carr meets a lot of three important people in Zurich, in Switzerland, in travesties. They are James Joyce, Vladimir Lenin, and Tristan Zara. Karl Marx is not there. James Joyce, Vladimir Lenin, and Tristan Zara. Karl Marx is not there. Okay, then, which one is not a part of the Wesker trilogy? Which one is not a part of the Wesker trilogy? Chicken Soup with Barley, Roots, and I Am Talking About Jerusalem. These are part of the Wesker trilogy. Chips with Everything is not part of the Wesker trilogy. Chicken Soup with Barley, Roots, and I Am Talking About Jerusalem. In which of the following plays by Carol Churchill does each actor play one role in Act 1 and a different one in Act 2? In Carol Churchill's one play by Carol Churchill, Each actor plays one role in Act 1 and a different role in Act 2. Did you know that, guys? It is in Cloud 9. Very important play by Carol Churchill. Carol Churchill employed dance, drama. And she wrote about Thatcherite England. What is the autobiography of John Osborne? Could be very important. Autobiography of John Osborne is Almost a Gentleman. Autobiography of John Osborne is Almost a Gentleman. What is the Browning version in the play The Browning Version by Terence Rattigan? What is the meaning of the Browning version? It is Browning's translation of Aeschylus's Agamemnon. Browning's translation of Aeschylus's play Agamemnon. And this is actually about a real life incident. Roots by Arnold Wesker is an example of dash. Roots by Arnold Wesker. Will you please read extra about all these works? Very important post-war works. Of course, it is Kitchen Sink Drama. Arnold Wesker's Kitchen Sink Drama it is. Lucky in Waiting for Godot represents what? I will may help you to read it. I know it is not visible. Lucky represents what? Is it an enslaved soul struggling for freedom? Is it good, intelligent people mentally? Yes, luck. This could be the answer because Lucky gives a monologue. It is an indication of his intelligence actually. Even though to us it doesn't make sense, it is considered to be an account of Lucky's life with Pozo. Good, intelligent people, mentally and physically controlled by man. Men of power, that is the meaning. Good, intelligent people controlled by men of power. That is what Lucky in Waiting for Godot represents. Okay, now World War II. Under whom did the socialist labor government come to power after World War II? You know, some of the social events could be very important. It is Clement Attlee. Socialist labor government came to power under Clement Attlee. What term was used to describe British territories? Whatever their status after 1947, whether they are independent or not, they were all called Commonwealth. British territories after 1947 were called Commonwealth. When did the National Health Service come into being? This could be important in paper 2 because social history is also there. Social history, 5th July 1958. National Health Service. Which one among the following was known as a conservative government during the 1970s? Conservative government. This is, I have dealt with a lot of social history of the 20th century in the Encyclopedia 3rd volume. But some of these could be important. Edward Heath. Then, who among the following is not a figure of the Angry Young Man movement? That you know. Angry Young Man movement. Yes, we are talking about NET because in NET they ask social history. Sometimes 20th century could be very important. So, we included a few questions. Angry Young Man movement. Sheila Delany is Kitchen Sink Realism. Sheila Delany is Kitchen Sink Realism. Not exactly Angry Young Man movement. Identify the connection between Peter Porter. Who is Peter Porter? Famous poet. 20th century post-war poet. Peter Redgrove and George Macbeth. They were all associated with the group. After the movement, immediately after the movement, there was another group of poets called the group. Did you understand? They are all very famous movements in the 20th century. The movement poets, immediately after that, the group was there. Martian poets you might know, Craig Raine. New Apocalypse you will know, Dylan Thomas. So, this question gives you members of the group. Peter Porter, Peter Redgrove and George Macbeth. Okay, so remember the discount code. Now, The Masters by C.P. Snow. The Groves of Academe by Mary McCarthy. They are very important writers. Pictures from an Institution. These are all examples of what kind of novels. The Masters, you should know. It is set in a university. Academe, the word is there. That means academy. Groves of Academe. So it is campus novels. The Masters, the Groves. Mary McCarthy wrote The Groves of Academe. It is campus novel. Okay. Then, with which woman writer among the following is space fiction associated? Space fiction. You might all know, Doris Lessing wrote space fiction. What is a space fiction called? It's a pentalogy, 5 novels. What is it called? Canopus in Argos. Canopus in Argos is Doris Lessing's space fiction. Then, identify the connection between Wendy Cope, Carol Ann Duffy and Jackie Kay. What kind of poets are these poets? Wendy Cope, Carol Ann Duffy. You will get such questions in GATE also. They are poets of gender themes. Poets of gender themes. Contemporary poets. Now post-war drama. Who said Osborne did not contribute to British theatre? He set off a landmine and blew most of it up. What is the meaning of that? It means he created such a revolution in British theatre. It is Alan Sillitoe. He created such a revolution in British theatre. It is Alan Sillitoe. The Theatre and Its Double by Antonin Artaud lays down the features of Dash. Antonin Artaud's Theatre and Its Double lays down the features of which of these? Theatre of Cruelty. Theatre of Cruelty. Towards a Poor Theatre is a groundbreaking work in the area of post-war theatre. Towards a Poor Theatre is a groundbreaking work in the area of post-war theatre, which investigates the experiments conducted by Dash in theatre. Do you know which is the post-war work? It is a post-war theater personality. It is Grotowski, very famous theater personality from Poland. Poor theater. Okay, remember. Already many years ago, they have asked questions on these different kinds of theaters. B.T. Bryant, a working class woman, is seen in which work? B.T. Bryant, a working class woman. She is in Arnold Wesker's Roots. Roots, Arnold Wesker's Roots. Some universities have it prescribed. Len, a young London man, and Pam, a young London woman, are central characters in which play of Edward Bond? Len and Pam from London. They are from the famous controversial play Saved by Edward Bond. Edward Bond's Saved. It led to the end of theatre censorship. Did you understand? Now, Footfalls, published in 1975, dealing with the author's mother's life. Footfalls. Who wrote it? Footfalls is by Samuel Beckett. Footfalls is by Samuel Beckett. The Ruling Class, a play by Peter Barnes, which centers on the theme of insanity. The Ruling Class is a play by Peter Barnes. It centers on the theme of insanity. It belongs to the genre of Dash. Peter Barnes is black comedy. Black comedy. Now, Tom Stoppard has written the screenplay of which movie? Which movie? He has written many screenplays, including Shakespeare in Love. He has written The Russia House and Brazil. That means both A and B. The Russia House and Brazil, both A and B. Which play of Harold Pinter derives its plot from his extramarital affair with BBC television presenter Joan Bakewell? A play by Harold Pinter derives its plot from his affair. It is Did you know the birthday party? Please read extra about all this. Bedroom Farce is a comedy by post-war playwright Alan Ayckbourn. Now, movement poetry. Okay. Would you like some questions on movement poetry? Who coined the term movement? That is very famous. Everybody would know. Who coined the term movement? Guys, will you please like the video, everyone? Who coined the term movement? It is J.D. Scott. J.D. Scott coined the term movement. Then, who edited the New Lines Anthology? It is Robert Conquest. Then, who among the following is not a movement poet? It is Ted Hughes. Ted Hughes is not a movement poet. Okay, Ted Hughes was associated with them, but he's not a primarily a movement poet. Then, which famous movement poet wrote Wits and Weddings? Everybody knows it is Philip Larkin. Philip Larkin wrote Wits and Weddings. You should know the poem in detail. Okay, guys, please read the poem. Now, which among the following is not true about movement poetry? The movement was essentially English in character is correct. They are romantic and embraced modernism is completely wrong. They were not romantic. They were anti-romantic. And they were anti-modernist also. Their poems were nostalgic for the earlier Britain is correct. Their objective was to prove the importance of English poetry over new modernist poetry correct. Okay. These are correct. Who among the following is a movement poet, Bolo? Some of these questions will come for WB set and K set, okay? G set, okay? Who among the following is a movement poet? It is all of the above. DJ Enright, John Wayne, Elizabeth Jennings, Donald Davy, all are movement poets. Dash was the first book of poetry of Philip Larkin. It is The North Ship. Who among the following is the biographer of Kingsley Amis? It is Zachary Leader. Purity of Diction in English Verse is the work by which movement poet? Have you heard of this? Purity of Diction in English Verse. Work by which movement poet? It is Donald Davy. And then the 55th question. Today we did fast. We have done 55 questions already. Last question. The Man with Night Sweats, centering on gay related topics. Who wrote The Man with Night Sweats? It is Tom Gunn. Alright, The Man with Night Sweats is by Tom Gunn. Okay, so we have come to the end of this session. I hope you liked all the questions, did you? Sorry for the little mix-up at the beginning because of my problem with YouTube. Thank you, everybody. I will now end and we'll be back tomorrow with the next topic. Tomorrow we have literary terms. Okay? Some of these questions will definitely be useful in the exam. Bye, guys. Please like the video and share it in your groups, will you? Bye-bye.